Let's talk about the case of Hariram, which I shared with you all yesterday. In this case, it was given that Hariram is having right heart failure and normally is not having any symptoms, but whenever he tries to perform certain activities, there is palpation dyspnea like symptoms present. So we need to find out from the given option that which particular activity is not going to exacerbate the condition or the symptoms for the patient. So from this particular case, I feel that we need to remember and we need to focus on three important things. The first one is right heart failure. The second one is from the option we can take the Trendelenburg position, and the third one is exacerbation of the symptoms. The first, let's understand right heart failure. So what exactly is right heart failure? So whenever the right heart fails to pump the blood towards the left side, which is coming from the body towards right heart, that is what we consider as right heart failure. So whenever there is right heart failure, we will see that patient is having edema over the limbs, because especially in the lower limbs, what is happening from the limbs, whatever the blood is coming, it is not getting pumped into the body. So that is why it will stay down in the limbs and we will see edema in the limbs. That is something you have to remember to answer this option, to answer this question correctly. The second point was Trendelenburg position, which is coming from your options. So Trendelenburg position is what? So in this, it was mentioned that laying position and Trendelenburg position, which means that patient is lying down as well as the feet are up and the head is down. So in this position, imagine what will happen, that the blood is rushing towards the heart from the lower limb. So basically what will happen, the load over the right heart is increasing. So that is going to increase the symptoms. So definitely that option B, which most of you, sorry, option C, which most of you are telling is the correct answer, is definitely not the correct one. So that is what you need to understand over here. And the third thing, increasing or the exacerbation of the symptoms like palpation dyspnea. Now basically in this, we need to understand that dyspnea, palpation can increase whenever the little bit of load is increased over the heart. Now let's go through the remaining option A, B and D. Option A tells that continuously climbing two flights of stairs. Now this definitely is going to put load over the right heart. So I am saying that let's just eliminate this option. This option cannot be correct. The second option is option B, which says that walking 3 miles per hour on the treadmill. Now, first of all, walking on treadmill is easier than walking on the surface. Second thing, normal speed of walking ranges from 3 to 3.5 miles per hour for any individual. Sometimes it might be 2.5 also, that is okay. Now, this is a normal speed of walking. Already it is mentioned in the question that patient is able to perform normal activities. Only thing is little bit of extra activities increases the symptoms. So this option makes some sense to me, but before looking at the option D, I am not going to answer that whether option B is correct or not. Option D says that running for shorter duration, running itself is not normal activity, is going to increase load over the right heart. So of course that answer is not correct, and the correct option is option B. I am damn sure after this reasoning and explanation, now you got it, that this is the correct answer, which is option B, and why it is correct answer. Still, if you have any doubts, you can always connect me over the comment section, or you can directly message me on my Instagram, or you can email me.